Hi, welcome to Foundations of Chemistry at LaGuardia Community College. My name is Chris Farley, and I'm a professor in the Natural Science Department here at LaGuardia. Foundations of Chemistry is a one-semester course primarily directed at students in the allied health professions. It is designed to introduce you to the fundamental concepts and techniques of chemistry. No previous knowledge of the subject is required, although you will need some basic skills like algebra. In the broadest sense, chemistry is the study of the material world around us. This includes the composition and structure of everyday substances like water or air, as well as the ways that these substances can combine together to form new substances, something that we call a chemical reaction. Of course, this also means that we'll need to learn about somewhat more abstract concepts like energy and how it relates to matter. If it sounds like chemistry is a broad subject, that's because it is. In this course, we're going to cover everything from the nature of science and measurement to the structure of matter at the subatomic level, all the way through the chemicals and reactions that make up the world around us and even life as we know it. This first chapter is really an introduction to some of these foundational concepts and mathematical skills. Since you've all satisfied the prerequisites for the course, I'm going to go through most of it pretty quickly, and mainly just focus on the last section, which may be new to you, scientific notation. Here you can see the assigned textbook for the class, General Organic and Biological Chemistry, Structures of Life by Karen Timberlake. If you've looked at the syllabus already, which I highly encourage you to do, you might have noticed that the lecture outline mostly follows the topics covered in this textbook with just some minor adjustments. These PowerPoint slides are also a companion to the textbook and come directly from the publisher, Pearson Education, although I've made some changes to them throughout. The first question many students have in this class is whether they need to buy this specific textbook or if they can get away with an earlier edition or another text altogether. In my view, chemistry is chemistry, and pretty much any introductory general chemistry textbook is going to cover these same topics. There are even some free, open-access ebooks that would be satisfactory. One of them is linked in your course syllabus. However, this is still the official text for the class, and if you do decide to use a different one, keep in mind that it will be up to you to make sure that you're keeping up with the class and studying the correct topics to match up with where we are. With that in mind, let's begin with Chapter 1, Section 1, Chemistry and Chemicals. So what is chemistry? Well, as I mentioned, chemistry is the study of the composition, structure, properties, and reactions of matter. In fact, chemistry happens all around you every day, and chemicals make up just about everything that you can touch, taste, or smell. Chemists, like myself, are scientists who study or take advantage of the natural laws that govern matter and energy. So if chemistry is the study of matter, then what is matter? Well, without getting too philosophical at this early stage, matter is just another word for the substances that make up our world. Here in this picture, you can see an example of an antacid tablet being dropped into a glass of water, and it undergoes a chemical reaction and generates these bubbles. The antacid tablet itself is matter, the water in the glass is matter, the glass is matter, the table that it sits on is matter, the air around it is matter, the bubbles that are generated are matter. Everything that you can feel or touch in this picture is matter. So matter is all of the physical substances that make up the universe, from stars and galaxies down to protons and electrons, or even smaller. Chemicals are also matter, but when we talk about chemicals, we usually mean something a little closer to our own personal scale and everyday experience. You wouldn't usually call stars or protons chemicals. This can also help to distinguish chemistry from physics, which is sometimes concerned with matter at these more extreme scales. It's a little more useful to think of chemicals as substances that have the same composition and properties wherever they're found. Now, sometimes in pop culture or news media, the word chemical is loaded with negative connotations or even used to outright scare you. But it's important to keep in mind that almost every substance you interact with on a daily basis is a chemical or is made up of chemicals. This includes wood, plastic, cottons, metals, and even water. This picture shows some tubes of toothpaste, which are all made up of different combinations of chemicals. Here we can see a table that shows some of the chemicals that go into a typical tube of toothpaste. Things like calcium carbonate, sorbitol, sodium lauryl sulfate, titanium dioxide, sodium fluorophosphate, methyl salicylate. And as you can see, some of them have rather complicated or scary sounding names. But many of these things are completely harmless. Some of them are found in everyday items like eggshells or wintergreen plants. And so there's no reason to be concerned or scared about any particular chemical that you would find in toothpaste for the most part. This brings us to our first learning check question. These questions are given periodically in the slides throughout the course to test your understanding of the basic concepts that have been covered. Some of them will be somewhat difficult, and some of them, like this one, are much simpler. So this question is, which of the following contains chemicals? A. Sunlight, B. Fruit, C. Milk, or D. Breakfast cereal? If you recall the definition of chemicals, it should be clear that all of these are everyday substances that we can touch or feel or taste, except for A. Sunlight. Sunlight is a form of energy, does not contain chemicals. In the next chapter, we'll see how energy and matter are distinct from one another.